the latest classification for Meghan. Royal author says that she's just like Wallis Simpson, very manipulative, very controlling. Do you think that's a fair description of Meghan, Alex?
Look, I don't know Meghan personally, right? And without sounding like a woke Me Too movement social justice warrior, I don't know her. So maybe this is just a huge pile-on through a misogynistic lens. But she seems like a bit of a nutter, doesn't she? Let's be fair. She seems pretty narcissistic and constantly in acting mode. But who do I know? I don't know the woman. But yeah. The fact that, you know, if you're in a relationship with someone, moving them to the other side of the world, enabling them to cut off all ties with their old life, their past, their family. If you love someone in a relationship, you're the one trying to build bridges. You're the one saying, do you think you should do that? And the fact that she sat there within that Oprah interview, you know, looking like she was the deer in the headlights going, oh, people will wave this towards me. I'm like, come on, if you love the man, really, and if you want to build bridges, you don't go to one of the biggest news anchors in America as little chat show hosts and sit down and start slagging off his family. So, you know, just on empirical evidence, let's say, I think she's an unpleasant person.
What I think, Reem, is that last Thursday, was it, when the two brothers were about to participate in the Diana Awards, the Memorial Awards for their beloved mother, albeit in a very separate way, William in London, Harry down the line from California. Those two can't even bear to be in the same room, even if one of them is on Zoom. I mean, it seriously is that bad. But it is still the only vague connection those two brothers have got is they are united in their devotion to their mother's memory. Good for them. And here's to Diana. But, you know, so what did she do on that very day? She announces this big banner announcement. Here comes my new lifestyle website. And I want you to give me lots and lots of
beige
money.
Beige maple leaf.
It's called American Riviera Orchard. The timing of that announcement was frankly ruthless and nasty.
No, I completely agree. And actually, I think that she probably just didn't think it through because she's so
in her
head. Yeah.
She thought it through.
No, I don't
absolutely
think so.
Thought it
I
through.
I think her.
No,
she
no,
is
no,
her
room.
World.
Not even that room. That's
no,
not true.
I think it's
she knows
true.
Exactly. You're
she
saying.
Know her
saying she did that by accident.
Yeah. I think she's so in her own world and so narcissistic. And I think Alex is right.
You think she did that by accident?
I don't think she did it on purpose. No, I don't think she thought.
Well, she didn't notice that Harry was going to be doing a Zoom link later on to the Diana Awards. She didn't notice that.
I don't think
she knew exactly what she was doing.
No, Kevin. No, no, look.
No, trust me, I'm older than you. I know that. Considerably older than you.
No, I think she probably didn't think about it. And actually, she's so narcissistic. All of, you know, her entire life, the launching of her lifestyle website, the launching of her own career, the fact that she's taken her husband away from his family, and they're not just any family, they are the royal family, taken them away. And actually, I think that she just doesn't think for once about anybody else but herself.
I think narcissism is usually someone who is quite controlling and very deliberate about their actions. It's a form of psychopathy and sociopathy. So I'm with Kevin on this. I think she timed it knowing it'd give her a bigger boost. Yeah. But you know what we don't talk about enough? The fact that she went through that phase of dressing like Princess Di, turned around and said, oh, I've got an eating disorder as well. Turned around and said, oh, the paparazzi are after me. I feared for my life. Even in that interview of Oprah did, the whole black eyeliner under her eyes, like when Diana did her famous interview. And I'm like, can you stop doing cosplay of your husband's mother? This is Oedipal and weird.
Dead mother.
Yeah,
it's
this is
very weird.
Messed up.
Yeah.
The reason the analogy is being drawn between Meghan Harry and...
Well, because Harry made that connection.
Yeah, but Wallis Simpson,
it,
Wallis Simpson and
just like my mother.
But Edward VIII was a very weak... Edward VIII was a very weak man as well, who was completely controlled by the far more domineering Wallis Simpson, who was narcissistic, controlling generally a slightly toxic presence. The reason that it's such a kind of striking similarity is the fact Harry's quite clearly pretty weak as well, because he should say, no, I don't think you should do this on the day I'm honouring my mother, albeit with... But instead, he meekly does it and
Harry
just lets her get it.
Harry's obsessed with her, isn't he? Yeah. So, I mean, the Oedipal complex
is
all on him,
it
isn't
is,
it?
Yeah,
it's really odd.
I absolutely agree. I really do think it is a kind of dependency thing where he actually doesn't feel... I don't think Harry himself is very well mentally, and I think that he has never really gotten over it. And again, we don't know them personally, and this is all speculation.
Well, I think we can know from Spare that he's not well mentally, because that's all he talks about.
And the you know, the thing with the cream, his mother's cream. I just can't even imagine it. But I do think it's really sad, and I think that he clearly feels dependent on Meghan, and that is why he won't, you know, set those boundaries and say, no, today is about my relationship with my mother. My brother and I are going to be doing this for her legacy. And instead of actually, you know, setting those boundaries with her, he lets her do as she wishes, and she kind of encompasses this sort of narcissistic persona in which everything is all about her. Yeah. It's all about Meghan, and she's the victim. Yeah. She's a victim of the press. Yeah. She's a victim of an eating disorder. And I do think it's incredibly sad. I think Harry seems to feel dependent on
her. As you say it, Reem, what a shame that she just didn't remember it was Diana.
What a shame.
She just didn't. It was an accident.